It's Wednesday, time for our weekly trip to the News Zoo.
Neil Anderson joins us again live from Suamico. Good morning, Neil.
Hey, good morning. You know, we talked a little bit early about the red wolf and the red wolf pups. Well, you know, this is the den building that's behind the red wolf exhibit. And we caught all the little ones up, and you can take a look right over here. We have Dr. Tracy Gilbert.
Good morning.
And Jessica. Jessica has one of the little wolves. And what we're going to do today, Doc, you know, we're going to give them an exam and vaccinations. And what do we vaccinate them for?
They're going to be vaccinated for distemper and parvo, just like your dogs at home will get. They're susceptible to the same diseases that dogs are. So he's going to, this is boy number one, we're calling him right now. And he's going to get weighed and vaccinated, dewormed, and we're going to put some flea and tick control on him as well.
Okay. And these guys certainly have grown since, what, May 22nd they were born? So, you know, I think they're close to, isn't it close to that they're weaning right about this time? So I know when Jess goes up to feed them, you know, they want to take the food from the parents as well. But you can see now Jess is wearing some gloves.
Yeah.
And you can see why. Yeah. Because these little guys have some sharp little teeth. You know, they are like most wolves. You don't want you to catch these little guys up. You know, they're fairly submissive and everything, and they'll go through this procedure. But this is really gives us an opportunity at this age to, as you can see, Doc is going over really from head to tail, checking out their overall condition, make sure everything's good, and then of course they'll be vaccinated. And Doc, what are we looking for as you kind of go over the whole body?
Well, we're looking to see if he's in good weight and body condition, especially around the weaning time. And when you have so many pups, six is a pretty good sized litter for these guys. It's difficult to evaluate from a distance how their weight is. This guy's very lean, but you can see how leggy he is too, mm-hmm. compared to a domestic dog. But he's in good body weight. He looks like somebody bit him on the tail back here. We have a minor little sore back here,
yeah.
But that seems to be healing. We're checking that all his reproductive organs are intact, and they are. And checking his heart, and just looking for any congenital problems or any signs of illness.
So you can see this is quite a process, and you know, we have six of them, and we'll do, you know, do one at a time, and then they'll be transferred to the den, and then once they're all settled back in the den, and of course then the parents will have access. Now, Doc, what are we vaccinating right here for?
This is distemper and hepatitis and lepto and parvo.
Okay. And then also what we're also going to do is microchip him, correct?
That's correct. We're going to do that next, give him a unique number so that he can be identified as who he is no matter where he goes.
And this is very important because, like I said, there's only, well, around 200 in captivity. Probably about 100 in the wild, so we want to make sure we know who's who, and as they follow, you know, their path through the rest of their life.
He's better than me at the doctor.
I was just going to say that he handles those vaccinations so much better than you.
Yeah. They do well. That's the
very
good,
brave.
The first one.
Well, Neil, thanks a lot. We'll check back with you the next hour, okay?